Hello everyone, welcome to another video. This is Pascal and our recording for Channel Fireball, and this week I'm going to be playing a spicy modern deck. So if you read my article this week, I've been talking about decks that I have on my bucket list. And, well, this was not on my bucket list, that's for sure. I just ran through, like, I went through a bunch of modern lists to make sure I didn't miss anything. And I ran into this deck, which I thought was kind of cool. And I'm trying to see if it's just cute or if it's actually good. I'm going to start with the idea that it's probably too cute, too slow, not interactive enough. But I could be surprised. So I'm going to try it and try to explain what's going on here a little bit. So it's essentially mono black. I took a list from a guy named... I don't remember. But there's only one list of that deck that 5-0'd the league. Maybe many people are playing it, but the only list that 5-0'd and was posted was by one Magic Online username that I can't remember. I'm sorry about that. But essentially here, the deck is mono black, and he actually, the person that I took the list from didn't have like white in this deck, but he had Lingering Souls, which I kind of understand. Like, he has a lot of ways to discard cards, so I'm guessing he doesn't cast Lingering Souls, but it just seems really low cost when he already had Bloodstained Mire in his deck to play God of the Shrine, and I just added two Marsh Flats in there just to up the count of red sources and black sources at the same time, and that just seems like a really, really low cost for, like, being two or three colors in Modern is so free. I understand he has Blood Moon and sideboard, but you only really need two swamps in play. You can fetch for them. That just seems really easy to me. So that's the only change I made. But for the rest, yeah, we're playing like fast lands here because it's free, and a Blood Crypt. And so that the red mana main deck is only in case we need to cast Squee, but also for Blood Moon in the sideboard. For the main deck, so it's got 8 1-drops, 4 Ruthless Sniper, a card I never think would see constructive play. It's a very good limited card, but in this modern deck, it might actually be reasonable, especially with Zombie Infestation. You get to discard 2 cards at the same time, so you get 2 of those triggers. And so this doesn't cost anything to activate. For only 2 mana, you can put 2 -1 counters on different creatures or on the same creature. So this might actually be somewhat powerful in this deck. Then we have Cryptbreaker, which is kind of weird because the deck doesn't play a lot of zombies. In fact, it plays only one zombie, and it's Graves Crabbler. This is not a zombie. This doesn't make zombies. This makes vampires. This is not a zombie. But it does work with Zombie Infestation, so it's a pretty nice way to recoup the number of cards that you discard with Zombie Infestation. You can then draw them back with Cryptbreaker, so it's kind of a way to fuel the Zombie Infestation when you don't have a Squee. Then we have 4 Call the Bloodline and 4 Zombie Infestation, which is the engine of the deck. I think the basic idea of in here, just glancing at the deck, is that we want one of these two enchantments in play, and then we want Squee. So Call the Bloodline lets us make 1/1 Vampire Knights by discarding cards, and Zombie Infestation lets us make zombies by discarding 2 cards. So if you have a Squee or even multiples, then it starts costing you essentially 0 cards to discard. Then we have, as interaction, Big Game Hunter, which is essentially another 1-drop. It's a 1/1 for 3 that you can destroy a creature with power 4 or more, and you can manage it for 1. So this kills Death Shadows, this kills Thought Not Seers, Reality Smasher, Tarmogoyfs, some of the biggest threats in Modern, for just a single mana, so it's a pretty nice card. 3 Liliana of the Veil, which is kind of weird. It seems really good in this deck. I could easily see going up to 4, but I'm going to start with the list that was the original list first. So we're starting with 3 Lilianas here. Then Grave Scrambler, a card that I only remember because I've played some Time Spiral Block Limited. So it's a 2/2 for 4 that if you paid the madness, it returns a creature. If you didn't, it doesn't do anything. So you really want to mana it. But for 2 mana, you get a Gravedigger that brings back... Well, that you get a Gravedigger for 2 mana, essentially. A 2-2 that brings back a creature. Which is pretty sweet because, well, first of all, it's a zombie for Cryptbreaker. Second of all, we have a lot of ways to discard cards. So you can buy back a Big Game Hunter, anything to discard a Cryptbreaker. If people kill your Cryptbreaker or your Ruthless Sniper, you can bring it back. And it's just a way to make card advantage out of discarding cards that is not squeeze. So it seems like it's just a card that is like your squeeze from 5th through 8th, basically. And then we have 2 Lingering Souls, which is kind of weird, especially because the deck didn't have any white sources to begin with. But, you know, if you discard it, then it's a pretty nice card to flash back. So I kind of understand why it's there. And Voldair and Perry, a card that we've seen played a little bit in Standard over the years that it's been legal. In this deck, with Claw of the Bloodline, those 1-drops, some Infestation, Lingering Souls, it just seems really easy to flip. And that could be very, very good, actually. It's a very powerful card. So I'm pretty excited to play with it. And, of course, it has Madness for 3 black. Then we have a 1 of Fatal Push, which I think after testing might become like, you know, a Fort Lyanna of the Veil. Just trying to streamline things a little bit here, so maybe like a Fort Lyanna of the Veil, but we're going to start with 1. A Dark Blast, which is a reasonable card against X1s, just like Ruthless Sniper. It helps us find Squee by dredging, or even Lingering Souls, but there's not that much cards that play with the graveyard, so I could see that Dark Blast being a little loose. And then we have a Driven Despair that we can't cast the front side of. Another awkward thing. But if you do discard it, then you can easily turn this into like a M2-2-Rack or Mind Twist by having our opponent discard a bunch of cards. But that seems a little cute. I think discard should probably not be here. Sideboard, straightforward. 2 more Dark Blasts. Gravedigger's Cage and the Hill Spell Bomb as Graveyard Hate. I don't know why those over like Leyline or Relic or Gravedigger, I kind of understand. The only card that doesn't really work with it is Despair and Lingering Souls. And like Relic would be annoying if you have a Squee in your graveyard or something. So I can understand Cage. But to me, if you have like 4 graveyard cards, graveyard hate in your sideboard, you should probably have Leyline, especially in a format where we have like dredge in the format. But I could easily be wrong. Like it's easy to just board in the Hill Spellbomb against a fair deck where you wouldn't want Leyline of the Void. Then a 3rd Lingering Souls, I assume for grindy matchups or matchups against like, for example, like Affinity, they have a bunch of flyers. 2 Collective Fatality against combo, burn, potentially infect if that still exists, and then 4 Thoughtseize against a combo, because our deck doesn't have a lot of, despite being mono black, doesn't have a lot of interaction except against creatures. So I think having 4 Thoughtseize in the sideboard against like Valakut or something is probably very important. Same thing for the Blood Moons here. So I will be playing a Magic Online League, and I'll see you there. Alright, welcome to round 1, and here we have a hand that it's I would call a little slow and loose. I would think that this deck wants Cryptbreaker or a Ruthless Sniper, maybe in a starting hand, then a Squee probably. This hand is kind of, it's still functional. It has Call of the Bloodline, which is one of the important cards. A card to discard to it, and then Voldair and Perry is kind of like a payoff. But we do have like a second call and a second pair that is kind of annoying. But I'll still try it. Like, I don't know what you can afford to keep, what you can't afford to keep. So we'll start by keeping them and see what happens. Alright, well, our hand was kind of Inquisition of Kozlex proof because of those 2 Call of Bloodline lines, so that's a good start. Alright, so took a call the bond line, so he might have a second discard spell. Or, like, maybe a way to just sort of call the bond line. Maybe Abrupt Decay. I'm going to start off here by just casting this Crypt Breaker. I'm going to get a Swamp. I don't think it's necessary to get this Blood Crypt. We don't plan on casting Squee. That's not what... We don't really ever want to have to cast it. But it might happen, and if so, it's going to be probably super late, and might have time to fetch a Blood Crypt. But for now, I just don't want to lose the two life for no reason. Okay, he's a Coilo. So this might be... Yeah, that's what I thought. This is black, white, Eldrazi. It's going to take Call of Bloodline here, and that's going to be rough. We still have Crypt Breaker as a way to discard cards, and now we just drew Zombie Infestation. Alright, so this might play out a little differently. So, alright, so I can make a zombie with Crypt Breaker and then, like, discard Lingering Souls. I can play Zombie Infestation, discard two things, but I don't think Zombie Infestation is very good here. I think I just make a zombie with Crypt Breaker. Discard that Lingering Souls. Relic of Progenitus. Interesting. Really? I guess I might have something to for the zombie. I don't know what to discard here. I don't really want to discard the Lingering Souls because he's likely going to exile it. But if he has a push or a path for my Crypt Breaker here for my token, then I guess that means he's not activating Relic, so yeah, we'll do that. We'll have to choose between exiling the souls with the Relic or pushing. He's pushing. So we're taking two. Then we can flashback Lingering Souls. Or make a zombie or cast Zombie Infestation. I think it's between making a zombie or flashbacking Lingering Souls. It'll be flashbacking Lingering Souls. Wish those were zombies. Sure, that's fine. With this, since we're not going to use it. Now we can flip Voldair and Paria. Just need to be able to cast it. So maybe we cast Zombie Infestation next turn. And if we draw a land, a third land, then we can Madness to Paria in. Wasteland Strangler. Alright. Alright, well, now blocking is not that good anymore because the card that was under Sculler is now in my graveyard. I don't think I want to double block either because I want to keep creatures for Paria. Paria, whatever it's called. Well, they're in Pariah. I think so. Alright, well, we'll cast this. It's the only kind of thing we can cast anyway. And call attack. With these two, I'm not blocking. And we really want to draw land. I don't know if I should consider making a guy just to block. I don't think so. I think you can take five. Oof, that's a beating. That's a huge beating. That makes Paria a lot worse. Alright, we still drew the land at least. We'll have to pass here. I don't know if I'm supposed to Madness it in now. In case he has like a removal, then at least we get to make him sack three guys. Nah, I think it's better that way. Because I think it's just better to block with my creatures than have Pariah flip anyway, because he's just going to sack spirits, right? Let's guard these two. We're not paying for this one. Nope. Cast that one, yes. Wow, this is an old zombie. Alright, so go to blocks. Like this, like this. I think so, right? Yeah, it's not so bad. Now, there's no point for me to keep playing lands. I just want to keep my cards in hand. I don't have anything to cost more than this anyway. So I'll just attack here. I can't even afford to attack. I'm just going to flash in another Pariah. Make a zombie. That's fine. I'll respond by discarding these two. So he doesn't have anything to put under his color. No. And then yes. That resolves. Oh, god damn it. He drew a path. I mean, you could have had it last turn, but that wouldn't have made any sense. I have to block here. We can't really attack here. Just one zombie is not enough to block this whole board because of the Shambling Vent. Draws a temple. Another land. Still passing. Another land. I think maybe now I can start attacking. Get 2/2s. I can double block the Shambling Vent. Take 3. That seems kind of bad. Not bad. Alright, now we'll attack. Thalnut's here. Activate Shambling Vent. This in. Did Sounds about right. Then, oh, Lingering Souls. God damn it. Okay, well, I make a zombie end of turn for sure. Because I use it to attack. That is not the worst. Oh, that's kind of cool. You can actually return a creature from an opponent's graveyard to their hand. So that's useful against, like, Dredge or Reanimator, or, like, anyone playing with their graveyard, essentially, with creatures. That's kind of cool. So... guess I can, like... I unfortunately cannot discard my two cards and cast a Big Game Hunter to have, like, three creatures in play, because I don't have a fifth mana. Maybe I can attack with a Pariah and a Zombie... Well, if I attack with my two Pariahs and a Zombie, I can instant speed have two guys. So if he doesn't block either of the Pariahs, I can kill him. That's not true. That's 9 damage. Okay, so I can't really kill him. Well, I could kill him if I attack with everything and he didn't block anything. No, it's still 9. I guess I can't kill him. So I guess I can attack with 1 Pariah, 1 Zombie. When he attacks me, I flip the tapped Pariah. Eat 3 of his spirits and then block. Yeah, that seems reasonable. I don't know if we can try a triple block. Alright. I could have flipped it right away, honestly, just to get 3 damages in. That might have been better. He's on his upkeep right now. I don't understand why he would have a step on his upkeep. Alright, draws. That's not bad. Okay, well, that was a reason to not flip net on my turn, because now I can flip whichever he's targeting. You might put a creature in my graveyard that's relevant. That would be pretty funny, but I don't know that until that resolves, so... discard those two. I have to flip now, because it's only in resolution that everything happens. Big Game Hunter, just put that creature back to our hand.
Finally, Drewski. Attack with this. No reason to attack with the other one, is there? Yeah, I guess that puts him down to 2, and my token can kill him. End of turn, discard 2. Is that a Yume? So, oh, kind of. It's kind of annoying. I have to kill something with it, which means it's just better. I'm better off not messing it in. No. I'd like to return it to my hand. Ooh. We're gonna go off with those Grave Scramblers. Alright, so I'm gonna path the other thing. That's fine. Pass. Alright. We were even protected against Reality Smasher because of Voldair Imperia and also Scrabbler into Big Game Hunter. Okay, so we're gonna probably board this out. I would assume this is gonna be good against a combo and stuff like that. Oh, he doesn't have that many small creatures, so I don't think Dark Blast is that good. He has like medium-sized creature. So I still think Rootless Snapper is probably reasonable. Lingering Soul is probably fine. That's about it, honestly. So maybe I have to keep this Dark Blast. I assume he's going to have a lot more graveyard hate. More relics for those squeeze and stuff like that. Not much I can do about it. Alright, back for game 2, and this is not a figured hand. We do have Squee and Ruthless Snapper with no way to discard cards. And that is a problem. So we're gonna mulligan. Alright. Gonna keep this one. Cryptraker, is that any good? Eh, it's probably not bad. We'll keep it on top. Split. Rest in peace. Alright. Then we're going to try to roll on that Crypt Raker. It's possible I should have played Zombie Infestation and literally just discard 4 cards. Not have been surprised that this should have been the play. Also, I should get my white source here in case I draw Lingering Souls. Same for Blood Crypt in case I draw Squee later. Oh, that was really stupid. I just took 2 damage for nothing. Or maybe not. I can just put a big game hunter in play.
Yeah, that's actually reasonable. Oh man, this in. Why not? It's just a 1/1. I can draw a card in this turn. Doesn't have colorless, so this draws the space, we're not gonna be killing any zombies. Draw a card here. And he's probably gonna path that Crypt Breaker is what I'm, or kill it, no? Alright. I think I just pass. We're gonna Madness into Pariah. That resolves. Well, I guess we could draw first. In case that changes our mind. Discard these two. Cast. And I think we can discard these two other cards. Because why not? It's tempting to flip the Pariah and start attacking for a bunch. Like make a zombie with the Crypt Breaker, then sack Big Game Hunter and two zombies to sack the Pariah. It's very tempting. That seems kind of dangerous if he has a way to kill Pariah, though. Yeah, I think I can still wait a little bit. So, we'll draw with this. Yeah, just attack with the Pariah. We'll make a zombie with the Zombie Infestation. Not the Crypt Breaker, because then I can just draw a card. Because obviously I have to tap the Crypt Breaker to get the zombie. Fair enough. Strong card. Alright, we'll respond. Draw and flip now, maybe. Yeah, let's do that. 1, 2, 3. Now we attack for millions. Make another zombie, and that should be game over. Alright, well, that was sweet. Rest in Peace is definitely not bad against us. It definitely does something, but we can still fight through. Welcome to round two, and we are on the draw here upon Mulligan. We're going to keep this. It's got most of the tools we need. Just no squeeze. All right. Six cards for our opponent. Scryed on top. And starts up with the Thoughtseize. And I assume his reaction is going to be, what the hell is going on? And I would think he has to take Zombie Infestation or Crypt Breaker here. And he took Grave Scrambler. Interesting. Not going to cast it. Because we can't. Our opponent. Oh my god. Our opponent just said in the chat that he was just trying to read the card, but he misclicked on it. So that's why he took it. Well, that's unfortunate. I think we're going to cast Crypt Breaker here. I think it's better than casting Rootless Sniper. I'm not sure. Alright, looks like Jund, maybe? Or some sort of Death Shadow? Alright, and we drew another Scrambler, which is kind of nice with the Scramblers in our graveyard. I'll just get a Swamp here. I'll have Zombie Infestation in play to be able to discard future Lingering Souls. Do I even want to play Zombie Infestation here, or do I want to play Grave Scrambler? Call the Bloodline. So I don't think I want to make a Zombie Interferon. Maybe I just play Call the Bloodline. Don't want to discard two cards just yet. Grim Lavmancer. Well, that's going to die to Ruthless Sniper. Just not now, because we don't have another land. I really need another land here. Because I can't discard and do something, so I guess I just play Zombie Infestation and pass. I don't really want to play... Maybe that would have been a reason to play Zombie Infestation last turn, so that I could actually, like, do something without having to draw land. Yeah, that was maybe wrong. I think him playing Grim Lavmancer probably means he's playing a regular Jund and not Death Shadow. Abrupt Decay. Well, we have another one. So that's fine. Alright, found the land. We'll play... Oh, it's still annoying. Stupid Call the Bloodline. Why didn't I play that? Alright, so I guess... Rootless Sniper is not for now. Still need one more turn. Discard this. Madness, yes. Return the other Grave Scrambler. Or Scrabbler. I don't even know what Scrabbler means. Someone who plays Scrabble? I know what Scrambler means. What the hell does Scrabbler mean? All right.
Squee. That's nice. Guess I can start by attacking. It's probably gonna shoot something. Or maybe not. Like, killing a Scrabbler just means I bring it back. In which case, I don't really want to play the Ruthless Sniper now, because then it's just going to die to the Grim Labmancer. Maybe that's not a big deal, because I can just bring back with Scrabbler. Yeah, that's actually true. This. Get a guy, this dies, but we can just bring it back with Scrabbler, so that's fine. Brob Decay, the Call the Bloodlined. We still have a Zombie's Infestation. Another one, that's nice. Let's go with these two. I could have discarded two more cards just to make sure I kill him this turn. Now, just needs a removal to stay alive. Still don't think we're gonna lose this. Scoop. That's probably that was for information, I assume. All right, post board, Lingering Souls, and maybe Blood Moon. Maybe we can get him. You might not expect it. I mean, you didn't see any red source this game. Although Behemoth is quite good against them. This is I think probably medium. Fatal Push is good. Dark Blast could be boarded out. I mean, it kills Grim Laughmancer. It might kill Dark Confident if he has it, and that might be big. So I'm gonna keep it. Not bringing the Blood Moons. Just keep it safety against Dark Confident. Alright, well, that's a good hand, but it's really missing a land and squeeze. Okay, that's better. Bottom. This is a lot more soft to discard spells, though. Nihil Spellbomb. Play this. Start off with Sniper or keep mana for push. I'll play Sniper. I don't have to cast a Call to Blood in next turn anyway. A Goyf. Cast that. Pat. Brought the K. Alright, that's bad for us. Crit breaker. Decent draw. Let's cast it. Pass. I wonder if Pack Rat would be good in this deck. Maybe as a sideboard plan. Although I doubt people will actually board out removal against us. We still have like Roldair and Pariah and like Crypt Breaker that they want to kill. Fair enough, go to combat. We'll push. Huntmaster? Olivia. Well, that one is very good. Jesus. I need Liliana the Veil. How do I beat that? Start by attacking. You might block. No blocks. And we'll pass. I haven't seen this in a long time. Alright, we'll discard a card. Discard. Dark Blast. I think Squee. The reason I would want to discard Dark Blast is to force him to crack the Spell Bomb, maybe. But this Dark Blast doesn't really do anything here. Ah, and he has an ooze now. So exile it. Probably pack this one up. Can't really deal with the ooze anymore, and yeah, just game over here. It's still tempting to keep to bring in the Blood Moons, especially on the play, just because you can get them. I don't think he has Dark Confident. I mean, guess we have a Ruthless Sniper to kill Dark Confident. So one Blood Moon. I have no idea what this the other card I should port out for. Maybe a Big Game Hunter. Yeah, let's start. Let's see with a Big Blood with a Big Game Hunter. I mean, he's gonna play around it, so I think Goyf, Olivia, and Ooze can all play around Big Game Hunter, so he could easily play around it if he wanted. We're gonna be on the play. And that is a weird one. Because if we want to Blood Moon him, We need to get Red Source, and we can't cast Lingering Souls. If we do that, I think I'm going to keep still. It's super slow, but I'm on the play. There's a chance I get him with Blood Moon. I'm just not going to fetch until turn 3, basically. If he has a discard spell, it's a little awkward. But then he just takes Blood Moon and we fetch white. Alright, so he has Thoughtseize. I would assume he has to take Blood Moon here, yeah. Even despite fetching him basic. So that actually turned out good for us.
Ooze. Fair enough. I think I might Lily and in minus. I think that's the play here. Don't really want to play Lingering Souls and have it exiled. So he does have Dark Confidant. That's kind of unfortunate. He's going to have one turn of Dark Confidant at least. Start off with plussing this. Discard Squee. Cast the Lingering Souls. Drop the K. Well, that's bad. But we might be able to just beat him down and have him die to his Dark Confidant with those Lingering Souls. Who knows? Maelstrom Pulse, those tokens, and then kill the Lily? Alright. I think we might just lost the game. On that sequence here. Okay, not the worst. He has a Abrupt Decay, but there's not much I can do about it. Yeah, I think we just cast this. Come on, Olivia, take 4. Alright, Terminate. That's the thing we don't mind him drawing. I think I should have just cast Lingering Souls here from my graveyard and just wait for to draw a fourth land so I can Madness in the Grave Scramble with the Zombie Infestation. Will he let me block? I think he might. I think he wants me to block. I think he has another Dark Confidant. Alright, he just has a Bolt. Alright, that's fine. I'll take it. I don't want to discard those Grave Scramblers. Scrabblers. Well, that's a gigantic Goyf. Alright. Call the Bloodline. Am I interested in that? I can block Goyf, gain one life. I don't dislike that. Now I have 2 things, so he can't Abrupt Decay that profitably. Yes! Call Against Command. That thing is not very good against us. I think at this point I just ignore the confident. Just gonna grind him out and have him lose life every turn. Or maybe every turn. Do I want to start off with Lingering Souls? Yeah, let's start off with Lingering Souls. Still don't need to... Grace Scramble yet. I'm going to get some flyers, start being down in the air. The vampire I want to use to block the Goyf. Ooh, Golgari Charm. That's a very good one against us. Jesus. That's a good one. It's good against us because it kills enchantments and also kills our tokens. That's pretty sick. Alright, we'll take that hit. We'll take that hit, but we'll be back for more. Return target creature. So return an ooze. Well, ooze is going to be insane. And we'll discard this. Yeah, we'll probably lose it at ooze. Just going to game him too much life. Have another creature that we have to block. There's one card left to terminate. So I can play Crypt Breaker. Play Grief Scrambler. Well, activate Zombie Infestation. Okay, so Crypt Breaker, activate Zombie Infestation, discard Scrambler and Squee. Return Ruthless Sniper to my hand. I can draw a card this turn, but I'm taking infinite because I don't really have that good blocks. So I think it's just better to Lingering Souls and then play Crypt Breaker. Or even just discard it. Yeah, this Cavern Goes is really messing us up. Wish I had more pushes for that matchup. Or even drawing Voldaren Paria would be good, although it would die to terminate. That's kind of rough. Drawing Big Game Hunter would be nice with a Scoif. So maybe I just want to do a line where I play Crypt Breaker and I draw a card. I just lose a lot of resources doing that, and I have to block... probably, like, the Goyf. Pass.
I guess there's only two creatures in the graveyards now. Still a 4/4 is kind of annoying. I could discard my two cards and like make a gang block, but he could terminate and then remove three creatures and I wouldn't do it. Oh, he doesn't attack with it. Do I still chump? Probably. So, block with this. Activate it. Drew another Squee. That would be good if the ooze wasn't there. I think I probably want to discard a Squee end of turn to force him to make the ooze a 4/4 so we can kill it with Big Game Hunter. Come on, Big Game Hunter. It's not it. Doesn't have green, so we can Grave Scrambler. Grave Scrambler this turn. Yeah, Grave Scrambler main phase. Sniper. And then pass. To activate in response. One, two, three. God damn it. Come on, I need to draw it. That is the real thing for boarding it out right here. If I had Big Game Hunter instead of that Blood Moon, I could Scrabbler back the goddamn Big Game Hunter. Stupid me. Attack with everything. Am I supposed to make a 2/2? Then I have two creatures in the graveyard, three. This can become a 7/7, just eats everything. I don't have good blocks at all. Just have to chump, right? I think I should have played a Ruthless Snapper here. not really helping. Yeah, at this point, I don't really have outs. I have to block everything. That's super bad. And, yep. He got us. Think so, right? One, two, yep. Yeah. He got us. That was a nice match, though. All right, welcome to round three. We will be on the play, and we will mulligan this. Of course. All right, I think that's going to be a keep. It's a little... like, it's going to be missing pieces. But we got two of the important ones, and now a third one. So I might actually have a game. Also, Zombie Infestation is kind of nice with Pariah, because it's just a... free mana way to discard a card, which is super powerful when you can cast this for literally just 3 mana. Oof, Amulet. It's not going to be a good matchup, I don't think. Pariah might be able to kill a Titan. We'll see. This will attack with this. Man, if we could flip Pariah this turn, that would be a really good spot to do it. We can't. Well, end of turn, discard Squee and Pariah. Wait, no, that doesn't work. So I guess Scrabbler and Squee. Play Scrabbler, and then next turn I can Pariah. Fair enough, so lots of mana. That should be a Titan. Good enough. Yep. Yep.
can get lands. A guy with some infestation. Yep. Chaos with madness. That's fine. What's gonna happen here? Alright, just gonna counter. So you'll double block. Kind of an interesting one. Not good enough though. So discard these two cards. Madness this in. Flip it right now. There isn't really a reason to wait. And pass. Hope that gets us here. There. I doubt it. I think he has probably another Titan in hand. Mainly because he didn't get Tolaria West. That usually means another Titan. Yeah. So he gets those lands. Give it haste. And I believe he can kill us with by getting a Vizuva and a Sunhome, giving it double strike, right? Yeah. Alright. That'll do. So, Thoughtseize is Blood Moon. Don't want Dark Blast. We don't really want Fatal Push. Ruthless Sniper is kind of bad. Big Game Return is reasonable. Lingering Soul's kinda bad. Don't really have anything better though. Maybe Collective Brutality?
Actually they play Sakura Tribe Scout usually. If they do, then those snipers and pushes might not be that bad. Collective Brutality might be just the best of those. Because it kills maybe an Azusa. And maybe it takes a pact from their hand. It's probably better than Lingering Souls. Yeah, maybe I should keep some Ruthless Sniper, but I don't really know what to board out. Problem with this deck is I feel like we don't really have a way to put a clock that's super quick. Call the Bloodline seems kind of loose. Yeah, I think I'll try that way. First. Alright, we have a Blood Moon. We have a Collective Vitality. Liliana's. Seems good. I'm not going to play the Bloodstained Mire yet, just to not show that we have red yet. Alright, so it does have a Sacred Tribe Scout. I'm going to take damages because I didn't fetch Blood Crypt turn one, but still think it was worth the information. So we're going to click Collective Vitality, two modes. These two things. Target opponent. Discard the Son of the Infestation. Take an Ancient's Thyrinx. And he has these. Okay. Still need to draw a land. Found Amulet. No mana. I think I probably don't discard anything here, but I'm not sure. Fair enough. Please don't have a Titan. Relic. Okay. I don't know if I'm supposed to discard like Liliana's here. I feel like if I have a Blood Moon, they're not going to really do anything. Yeah, I'll do it. Come on. At least I have a big game on turf. You top decks a Titan here. That's fine. All right, so I do it. Wait. Why do I not have a graveyard here? Is there something I don't understand? Oh. Oh, they're both like... that's weird. I can't... Oh my god, I should have stacked the other way. Now I don't get to bring it back. Because it's just in my graveyard. Okay. I thought they were both in my graveyard when this was happening, but I guess that wouldn't make sense. It's not a huge deal, but it could be. Could easily turn out to be. especially since I can draw this third land. Kill this. Thrag Tusk. Okay. Something. God damn it, where does this land? I think I discard. Don't really want to discard Pariah, though. But if I do draw a land, I'm not going to get three black, so... If I draw my third land and I play Blood Moon, I'm not going to have three black because of Blood Crypt, so... It's fine. And this Behemoth should be in my hand. There we go. Making a 2/2 every turn is probably going to race Thrag Tusk. Not casting Disthoxies. Just making a 2/2. Start attacking. It's getting in like 6 damages in the turn. Alright, he concedes. Sweet. I knew he has Sekhra's Tribe Scout for sure now, so maybe those are reasonable. Instead of... Maybe Pariahs are not very good. Alright, it doesn't have a Blood Moon, but it has Collective Brutality, and a Crypt Breaker, and a Squeak. I think I'm gonna have to keep it. Although this seems like a nightmare matchup that maybe I should try to mulligan into this Blood Moon, or a Thoughtseize. Collective Brutality is kind of like close. It doesn't hit that many things. It's not as good as Thoughtseize, but it's still something. Amulet. Oh, Dismember. Aggressive. Alright, I'll have to Collective Brutality this turn. Is there a reason to do it this turn? So, the upside of playing Collective Brutality this turn is maybe hitting Serum Visions, Staring's, and then, you know, Summoner's Pact, but Summoner's Pact, you'll likely not be able to cast this next turn. If I cast Call of Bloodline, that means I can make 2 tokens next turn. One on my turn, one on this turn, but also means I'm not casting Collective Brutality. So, if I use 2 mana, so I might as well just use it now. And I guess I can two modes and just drain because it's free because I have a squeeze in hand. Right. Alright, he has two summoners packed. Hornet Queen, Explore, and Explosives. Alright, Explosives is going to be pretty good against all our vampires. So since he already has a threat in Hornet Queen, maybe I don't want to touch Summoner's Pacts. But on the other hand, he doesn't have a lot of mana here. So we could just like attack this Explorer and then keep the other Brutality in our hand for a long time. Actually, I like that. Just take the Explorer, hope he gets mana screwed for a long time. I guess he can get Azusa with Summoner's Pact. It doesn't really help. Explosive for 3? What? Liliana, maybe? Yeah, maybe Liliana. That was kind of aggressive, but sure. Make a guy. Oof, Blood Moon's a good draw. Oh, that was why he had explosives. Okay. On 3. That was actually smart. Think about it. So I'm definitely discarding a card. And do I play my land here? Probably. Pass. Make a guy on his turn. Discard and call the Bloodline. Attack him. We'll still keep a Blood Moon in hand because there's like a possibility it taps out one turn and I can Blood Moon him and that actually just drains him 2 mana the following turn to blow the explosives. So it's not completely unuseful. That is a very good one. Jesus. Yeah, that's a good one. Oh, and I'm super dumb. I forgot to activate Call the Bloodline on my turn. Forgot that it's only one turn. Well, I didn't know that, but forgot about it, I guess. Yeah, we'll attack. Should have done that end of turn. Oh, that's not true, because now I can cast a Grip Breaker. Okay. Yeah, I definitely cast it. Kill the Bailiff if he blocks my 2/2 next turn with my Collector Vitality. I can -2/-2 drain him. Maybe it was wrong to play Crypt Breaker here, because then that just spends 2 cards in my hand, a land drop and a Crypt Breaker. And I don't think I'm ever going to draw with the Crypt Breaker. I just want to attack him, so that could have been wrong.
If I had another untapped zombie this turn, that would definitely be alright. Alright, so he probably drew an untapped... oh no, Reclamation Shade? Interesting. Well, now we can win the game. Right? Unless he has another land. If he has another land... Alright. I'll tell you what happens if he plays land or not. So if he doesn't play a land, we play Blood Moon, and he can't pay for Pact. Because he can blow up the explosives, but then he only has 3 mana left. So we actually just win the game on this spot here. Maybe he has Simon Spirit Guide. That wouldn't be impossible. Still worth trying. Do I Collective Brutality first? Yeah. With 2 modes, drain. It's not worth looking at his hand, I think. Could have discarded to call the ball line, maybe. It's not really worth keeping. I should have just looked at his hand. Yeah, that was stupid. Oh, I'm so dumb. He has 2 mana up. He can blow the explosives on my turn. That was really stupid. But I still don't think he has outs here. Like, he's gonna pay for it and just do nothing. Well, that was nice. Did not expect to win this matchup, but we got there. Alright, round 4 here. And we are on the play. We are going to keep this hand. And start off with Cryptbreaker. Treat up Village. Sounds like we're going to be playing some fairly slow deck. I would think that this is like black green, or this might be some sort of devotion green deck. Mono green. Definitely some sort of devotion green deck. Or it's mono green stompy or something. I'm gonna make a guy here. Return this. I'm gonna play this. Play this. Make a guy now, I believe. Pass. Triangle Root Geist. Fair enough. Do I block this thing? Probably. Probably gonna have a pump spell. Okay. Draw. There, Pariah. Game Hunter is kind of nice. We just pass here. Maybe attack with the zombie. Nah, I'll draw.
Fair enough. Works. Maybe I go to blocks here. Like block here. And no, sorry. Block 3-2. If he plays a pump spell, then I play a pariah and I sack everything. Dismember that. Yeah, I'm still definitely doing what I wanted to do. We'll draw a card. Pretty cool, especially since he played a creature pre-combat. attack with this. These two, flash this back, and keep Big Game Hunter up in case I have to kill a gigantic creature that's been pumped. Fair enough. Fair enough. Okay, so 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So I take it and he's dead, right? Oh wait, this is reach. But I can kill it with a Big Game Hunter, so yeah, he's dead, I'll just take it. In fact, I don't even have to show him the Big Game Hunter. Right? I just make it not a zombie, blocks it. No, I have to show him. Alright, so this is like a mono green stumpy deck. I think Collective Vitality could be okay. I don't know how many one drops they play, but maybe Dark Blast is fine. What's bad in my deck? I think this is probably bad. Dark Blast, Fatal Push, we'll keep those two. Liana, yeah, everything is fine. Maybe I want a Collective Vitality over this Dark Blast. All this is a one mana correction. Yeah, I really don't know if Dark Blast is that good. I have honestly no idea. I think Lingering Souls might be a little loose. He has trample stuff. Alright, let's bring in this and like maybe a Lingering Souls or the second Dark Blast. I have no idea. Let's have like a Lingering Souls. Alright, let's keep. Alright. Experiment 1. That's something that would die to Dark Blast. Start off with Cryptbreaker or Ruthless Sniper. Maybe. I feel like Rootless Knighter is better because we can just play Call the Blood on turn 2. I think Rootless Nightmare is better. I think it's better for the sequencing and the following turns. I think Scribbreaker is not going to do a lot because we have the Call the Bloodline. Alright, we're going to get beat down. Because we're on the draw, this game might be rough. Although these guys are lifelink, so it's kind of cool. But this is trample. Take six here. Relic. Ooh, Big Game Hunter is a good one.
So we can activate this, discarding this, and I'm not going to activate Ruthless Sniper because we won't have extra mana. I don't know if I'm supposed to keep a blocker. I think I might triple block or something this turn. Aggressive. Like, I have to worry about how I play with Dryad. With my squeeze. Dryad Militant. Instant of sorceries. No worries. No problems. Probably has a Spect of Hydra if you played that main phase. It's kind of cool that this dies to this. Should be enough. I could force him to fire an aspect of Hydra. Have a problem with that. Two? Well, if he has two, we die, right? God damn it! we died. I could have blocked in a way that I don't die if I just put this on here. Yeah, maybe it was dumb. Maybe you should have played around two. Alright, so he has Dryad Militant, he has Experiment 1, so definitely want that Dark Blast over that Lingering Souls. But that's about it. Only one land. I think we have to mulligan this. It's a good hand, especially with Big Game Hunter, but I just have one land. Alright, that might do it. He's in a multi 5 too. 4 now. Crit Breaker. Go turn 1 Sniper. Turn 2, we could play Crit Breaker. And turn 3, you could shoot something. Yeah, I guess I'll keep it.
I think I'll make a guy and kill the Dryad Militant. Or I could plus Liliana, which is not that good. Yeah, I should have killed the Dryad Militant and attacked. It's fine. Though. Not really a big deal. Plus it, discard Squee. This. Again, should have attacked first. Just missed points. For no reason. Because this is going to come back untapped. That was stupid. Because I'm not going to double block here. Just let Deliana go to one. Discard to Squee, kill the experiment one. Hopefully kill the Geist with a zombie token. One more.
Alright, round 5 here, and we're playing to maybe 4-1 and get a bunch of chests. We will be on the draw, and we're going to keep this. We have all our colors, and we have a Zombie Infestation with Grave Scrambler. Just need us a Squee here. This could be nice. Maybe that tapped. Now, we have two Grave Scramblers, so that's kind of like a Squee. Blood Crypt, Bloodstained Mire. This might be. Alright, so no Death Shadow for us this league, or I guess that could still be that, but very unlikely. So is that Burn? Cathartic Reunion. Oh, this is Dredge. Oof. Dredge is going to be a horrendous matchup, I would think. We're gonna need these sideboard cards. Yeah, I'm not sure how we can possibly win this matchup. Ruthless Sniper's kind of nice against Narcomoeba and Blaghast. Fair enough. Yep, get a bunch of guys. don't think it's worth making a guy here. Or maybe it is, actually. I'm not gonna use this big game hunter anyway. It's pretty useless. I guess I could have used it as just like a guy that I can play. Maybe Voldair and Pariah is a start. That. Discard these two. Madness. The Pariah. The blocks are free. We could flip Pariah if we wanted to. Not necessary here. Fair enough. He's gonna dredge a bunch. Found a conflagrate. So that's how we're gonna die. Pariah's amalgam. This alright, let's do some math. He has 7 cards. He even has a Scourge Devil in the graveyard. Scourge Devil. Sure. Could probably attack. I'm not going to win by sitting back, so I'm going to attack and hope that this works. He's 2 conflagrates. It's very possible that I should have kept... some blockers. I don't know, actually. I should have kept a land in my hand, maybe, so that I can bring back. So I can make 2 zombies this turn. Because now I only have 1 card, so I can't discard 1 to the zombie infestation. Oh, I forgot that I can use this thing to maybe stop one of his creature to come back. It could be useful. So if I take it, it's 5. It's 12, I go down to 4. So I can't afford to not block because then I die to conflagrate. So I have to block a few things. So if I block the prized amalgam... Let's say I double blocked it, then I take 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I'm down to 7, I still die to conflagrate, so I have to block 2 things. So if I block 2 things, I still die to conflagrate, actually. So I don't have to block 2 things, and then Pariah flip. So I should do that pre-blocks. And he just killed a Pariah post-combat with the conflagrate, and I have no chance. And I still had to do that to not die.
No, I don't block, right? No reason to. Loam, fly great for literally 10 and kill me. Alright, GG. Even if he didn't see the line, he can still just kill. He's probably going to kill my Pariah, and then I have no chance. Loam is actually reasonable. Can keep them off like green sometimes. I can't loam and kind of like stall that at the game. Arc Blast. Reasonable if I have spell bombs and cages. So these are considerations. Push is pretty bad. This is pretty awful. Big Game Hunter is pretty bad as well. Liliana's a Unihorse. Alright, so these for sure. I can board out at least one of those. I can have a Lingering Souls in. So I think Dark Glass is pretty bad because of my Rootless Snipers. Board that out. At least Big Game Hunter kind of like works with my deck, as I can get a 1-1 for essentially free when discarding a card. Yeah, there we go. We've been pretty lucky at drawing Blood and Moon whenever we boarded it in. Alright, I'll keep this hand. We don't have red, but I have like the Ruthless Sniper, the Crypt Breaker, and the Zombie Infestation. We'll start with the Crypt Breaker. Since we have Zombie Infestation there, get a few zombies quickly. Star Loam and Prized Amalgam. So I don't know if I make a zombie or I play a Zombie Infestation. If I play a Zombie Infestation, then I discard Sniper and Moon. Discard Sniper and Moon. Make a 2-2. Next turn, land Grave Scrambler. Return to Sniper. Play it. I sort of go off. Yeah, that could work. So he didn't dredge the loam. So he's looking for another land, probably. Oh, he did. Okay, he did loam now. Okay, so he probably found that land. Okay. And he has a Conflagrate, so it's going to be rough because Conflagrate is good against this line that we're going to take. Not bad. Not a bad draw. Could discard a scrambler and land. Do I know he has loam in his hand? He did dredge loam. He didn't. He discarded it. He dredged a loam, but discarded it to the looting. So I don't know. I think we should wait for Nihil Spell Bomb. I don't think we have to do it now. Although, it's possible that he conflagrates. So I should wait on his draw step. Yeah, I think he could conflagrate next turn and kill a Crypt Breaker which is our engine right now. So yeah, I'm gonna nil spell on his draw step, I think is the right step to do it, so he doesn't get value with that Neonate. Okay, that was really bad. I should have attacked first. Because he was gonna do that anyway, right? That was real dumb. So am I supposed to do it now? I think so. Don't want him to get a loam. God, I sequenced this turn horribly. Now I drew Blackleaf List, which should have been the land that I played. Should have attacked first. Alright, well. Wow, so he did have a Lightning Axe for upkeep. Alright. It's dead. Okay. Madness, yes. We'll return a Crypt Breaker, I think. Yes, I can draw a turn a card this turn. Alright. Oh, god damn it! He found another Conflagrate. Still not as good anymore, though. Let's guard these two. Do I draw? How do I sequence this? I can attack for 9, put him down to 5. He can flaggers for 5. Yeah, definitely do that. Flashback this and attack. He can't conflagrate for enough. He can conflagrate for like 7. Alright, got there. Game 3 now. Still same sideboard. Alright, well, can't say no to that. It doesn't have a discard outlet, but it has Nihil Spellbomb. We have red for Blood Moon if we draw it. He's on a mold of 5. And he scryed on top. Faithless Looting. Thogging an Imp. I don't know if it's worth just Nihil Spellbomb now. Well, we did draw a Song Infestation, so that's pretty good. I don't know. It's so hard to know when to Spellbomb. So the upside of doing it now is that I don't let him put back a dredge card in his hand. One thing that I can do is I can just play the Spellbomb, wait to see what's in his graveyard when he dredges, and then like maybe keep slow rolling it. I think that's probably better. Although he only has like 3 cards left. I think I'll wait. But
put a stop on his draw step, depending what happens. Alright, so he dredged an imp. Life from Loam. It's fine. Do I exile now? He has Loam and Imp in hand. Yeah, it's probably a good moment to do it, because then he can looting and... Yeah, let's just do it now. Gonna cast Imp. Oh, Maelstrom Pulse. That was the last card. This card, this, and this. Something else. Yeah. Another spell bomb, not bad. Fine. Blood Crypt. Of course, draw Lingering Souls. I mean, to be fair, we discarded the Goddess Shrine, so we couldn't fetch for it. Attack with this. Blocks. We can spell bomb. Not a great draw. Damn it, are you kidding me? We're gonna lose this game. Oh my god. Maybe I should have waited for this spell bomb. Jesus Christ. Oh well, that's a good top deck. Won't be able to Loam anymore. So he has Loam, and Imp in hand. That was an insane top deck, I'm not gonna lie. Alright, let's jam it. Yeah, I think I definitely misplayed with the other spell bomb. I don't know. Like, yeah, I think so. Yeah, that had to be not a good play. Drew two, makes sense. Wants to hit some lands. Draw this card outlet. We'll block here for sure. plus looting. He's gonna find a land. Oh, he dredged, so he did find a land already. And he has a conflagrate. Yeah. Already had a conflagrate. Nice. I'm not going to flashback souls here or mana scrambler. I'm just going to kill two things with sniper. Oh, it's Manus. It's so random to discard as Manus. Alright, down to 7. Cathartic Runion. It's probably gonna draw 3 cards. Yep. No reason to dredge. No, he's gonna slow roll the land here, I think. I could actually count if he has lands left in his deck.
Alright, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Yeah, he has to have the lands left in his deck. I'm at 7, I think I should have chumped something. So I might die to stupid fly rate. I'm gonna learn your souls. I need to start attacking. Yeah, I need to start attacking. Gotta kill this guy. No lands, interesting. No attacks either. Discard this and... this. Maybe I should put counters. Do it again. Okay, so the first one I don't, so I put it in a graveyard. Second one I do, so I want to bring it back.
I attack with everything. He takes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Goes to 4. So maybe I can attack with just the flyers. I can actually just attack with everything in Ruthless Sniper, the prize amalgams. Just mess up, maybe. Oh, I just messed up real big time. I don't have another card to discard to Infestation. Oh my god. I think I just punted the match. I thought I would be able to make two zombies. Now I can only make one. I actually can't. I only have one. It's in play. So we can kill it. Conflagrate. Yeah, if he has a land, I'm dead. I just threw away the match. So let's like put a counter on Prize Amalgam here and another one. Is it 2/2? He has how many blood ghasts? 1, 2, 3. Oh my god. I'll die to land. And I didn't discard a scrabbler. Oh my god. I really thought I had another card. Or I could just act this card as a scrambler easily. Alright, well. I have to do this now. Oh my god, I threw away this game. I must have thrown away this game like 12 times. Minimum 12 times. I deserve for him to have a land. I deserve it. Yep, he has it, and I deserve to die. Jesus Christ, I cannot believe I punted this so badly. Actually, like, my punt was beyond not even having the other land. The other card in hand, like, I should have just not attacked. Not attack with as many creatures. That was ridiculously bad. I don't know if I still lose here. I think I might have still lost. Like, I keep maybe... Let's not attack with, like, the spirits or something. And, yeah, I just attack with the spirits. If he does that, I can, like, snipe two block ass. Actually, maybe he starts with Conflagrate. Yeah, he probably starts with Conflagrate. Kills a sniper and other things. And, like, a spirit and a zombie. I make a 2/2. I can make a 2/2, shoot two things. Even, like, play a scrambler or bring back something. And... You have two amalgams or 3/3, so I have to block them. I block gas. I go to like 4. I go to 3. I take 4, go to 3. And then I can probably swing back for lethal. We're close to it. Anyway, it should have been a game now. It hasn't been because I punted multiple times. So yeah, I'm gonna concede this. But yeah, so we lost this. My fault, entirely my fault. So a little recap here. Let's do this here. I think that the Ruthless Sniper are kind of loose. They felt very hard to actually get going. You can't get that going like in early turns. It has to be by turn 3 minimum. So I don't know if that's like good enough. But I did like the rest of the deck. Cryptbreaker was nice. Big Game Hunters, Call, Zombie Defeat Station, Squee was great. Didn't draw Liana a lot, but seems really good. Grave Scrambler was better than expected. Mainly because I've literally never played with this before, and this was actually pretty good. Ringer's was fine. This was, I mean, we never drew it, and there was a lot of matches where I just didn't think this was ever going to be good. So boarded that out a lot. So I could see that. Could see having like maybe more pushes to have a little bit more interaction. Although the deck seemed pretty good against any creature decks, so I wouldn't be worried about that too much. But like these three slots and those Ruthless Sniper could easily become other things. But yeah, that's pretty much it. We did play against a wide variety of decks. I mean, it's not true. We did. But we didn't play against like Eldrazi Tron or Grixis Shadow, two of the most played decks. I would want to see how this deck plays out against those before me making any big judgments. So anyway, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next week.